Guess not all of Vesemir's teachings have receded into oblivion.
A Witcher can forget to eat, to drink, to breathe even. But a Witcher never, ever forgets to care for his blade.
Yeah, I used to repeat that incessantly. Never tired of doing it either.
What creature was it?
Huh? Creature?
One that gave you the scar over your left eye. It's new. I don't remember it.
Souvenir from the Cockatrice of Spala. Another addition to the collection. Nothing special. Yours has healed beautifully, though.
Avalok. He prepared some special ointments for me. But that was before the curse gripped him. I wonder where he is now.
We lifted the curse. He's at Kaer Morhen, waiting for you.
Are you serious? You must be. You'd not jest about something like that. A nice thing to wake up to.
You trust him?
Avalok? He's not let me down to date. Not once.
Why exactly is Avalok helping you? Sages have never been fond of humans.
He doesn't do it for me. It's about my power. As if it could ever be about anything else. Avalok tried to teach me how to control my ability. He was also making sure I didn't fall into Eridan's hands.
What's Eridan after? What's he want from you?
What everyone wants. Control of my powers. His homeworld faces annihilation. Eridan's decided to invade ours. Brilliant, wouldn't you say? Can't achieve much on his own, so he needs to bring an army. Except his navigators can't possibly move him and thousands of NL between planes. Their abilities won't allow it.
Whereas yours will.
Exactly. And if I die in the process, well, that's a necessary sacrifice.
How do you ever start traveling with Avalok?
As soon as I'd left you and Yen on the Isle of Avalon, I found myself pursued. Eridan and his Red Riders were on my heels. I fled through many worlds, many times. They came very close to catching me once. It was then that Avalok appeared, out of nowhere. He found a portal and took us to a world where Eridan couldn't find us for, perhaps half a year.
The world where Eridan couldn't find you, what was it like?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
Try me.
People there had metal in their heads, waged war from a distance, using things similar to megascopes. And there were no horses. Everyone had their own flying ship instead.
Ciri, stop fooling around.
Told you you wouldn't believe me. We should have stayed there.
So why'd you return?
I thought the hunt had lost my scent for good. I thought I was safe. Besides, I wanted to find you. You and Yennefer.
You were looking for us. We were looking for you. Times I thought you were just a step away. Other times, felt like I was going around in circles.
I'm not surprised. There were times I fled pell-mell headfirst and forward.
So tell me how it happened, step by step.
Eridan located us mere moments after we landed on Ard Skellig. Soon after, he and his riders surrounded us. I thought it was over, the end. Turned out Eridan had other plans. He produced the phylactery, uncorked it. A fog enveloped us, and Avalok began gasping for air.
That's how Eridan cursed Avalok, triggered his transformation into Uma?
Yes. He didn't wish to kill him. Humiliation, that's what he was after. But Avalok refused to succumb without a fight. He cast a spell that wrought havoc in the Hunt's ranks.
And in a full half of a forest on Ard Skellig.
Yet it also gave us time to flee. Avalok opened a portal. I leapt in. He was supposed to follow right behind me, but something went awry. Impaired by the curse, he failed to reach the portal in time. We had agreed that if anything went wrong and we were separated, we would meet at his hideout in Venon.
But you failed to meet there.
Yes, we failed to. once through the portal, instead of at Avalarch's hideout, I landed right in the middle of Crookback Bog. I barely escaped the Crones. And then there was the Baron. You know he took me hunting. I killed a wild boar with my sword.
I heard.
A coincidence, really. I had no desire to hunt that day, but it felt wrong to refuse. I'd taken nothing remotely resembling a hunting weapon. I simply hadn't intended to hunt. I was wandering through the forest, breathing deep the air. And then I heard a strange sound. Unsettling.
Boar attacked you?
Mm-hmm. Big as a bison, and lumbering straight at me. And all I had was my sword. Had to manage.
Did just fine, judging by how the Baron's men remember it.
Simple soldiers, the whole lot. But we got along splendidly. A shame I had to leave. Flee. But I didn't want to bring the Wild Hunt down on them. Apart from which, I knew by then the curse was progressing. So instead of looking for Avalarch, I decided to find you and Yen.
So how do you even meet a man like Horson Jr.?
You and Yennefer were nowhere to be found, and I needed someone who could fix the phylactery. No ordinary craftsman would do. I needed a mage, one with extraordinary powers. Dandelion took it upon himself to help me. It was as if his honor depended on it. He arranged a meeting with a mage, but it proved a trap set by the temple guard.
Failed to mention that.
Probably didn't want to worry you. Later, we learned the guard did that sort of thing regularly, in the hope of nabbing anyone who collaborated with mages. We needed to find another way. That was clear. Then Dandelion said he knew a man who owned a piece of Novigrad, as he put it, could do more than others. He was certain to know someone who could fix the phylactery.
Horson Jr.
Mm-hmm. I suspected it might not be the best idea, but I was desperate. I had no choice.
You suspected right. Horson was not the ideal partner in crime.
Damned simpleton got it in his head that we cheated him and kidnapped Dudu.
Who you promptly freed only to have to flee to Temple Isle. Great idea.
We hadn't planned it. Had no time to consider. We'd just bolted. I didn't even realize the guardsmen were driving me into a trap. Suddenly there I was, and I knew I had to disappear. At once.
And that's when you landed back in Skellige.
The shore of Hindisfjall. The first pleasant place that came to mind. Kjalmar and I used to swim there.
Wait, so you actually wound up there by accident? I thought you and Avalok had arranged something.
No, he simply sensed me use my power. Just as Eredin can sense where I am, where I travel. In fact, Eredin arrived soon after I did. His riders in tow. Once again, things happened quickly. Lofoten, the Hunt's attack, my flight. And then, dreams. Just dreams.
What did you dream? I've had nothing but nightmares lately. Pretty horrible.
Likewise, for the most part. In one, a monster grown from a stillborn child chased you. Ugh, that was horrible. Had a few nice dreams. For example, in one we sat around a fire, drinking good wine, and all around people danced and laughed.
I like that one a lot better.
Me too. But these dreams, and the others, ended in some tower. No matter what I'd dream, in the end, I would enter a tower.
Recognize it? Know where it might be?
Not sure. I don't think so, but there was something familiar about it. And something terrifying. The tower was stark and dead. But at the same time, I felt I had to enter it.
Did you?
No. Dreams all ended with me searching for the entrance. And the last time, instead of the tower, I saw your grizzled face. If not for the scar over your eye, I'd have thought I was still dreaming.
I was afraid you were dead. Found some dwarves here. Said they'd try to wake you, but you were cold as ice, and you weren't breathing.
And yet you came in.
Who listens to dwarves these days? Speaking of which, they're probably getting antsy. We should go. Got a boat on the beach. Once we land, we'll head for Kaer Morhen on horseback.
Right. Conventional means of travel. They're just better.
Though a portal would be quicker.
And draw Eredin to us immediately. Rather not risk it. Besides, I hate portals. Damn. Listen, we gotta think of a way to...